اهلا بيكم اعزائي الطلبه والطالبات، ومع حلقه جديده من ماده ساينس لبريب 2 تحت رعايه واشراف وزاره التربيه والتعليم. احنا وستيل ان يونت 1 ان ليسون 3. النهارده ان شاء الله وي ار جوينج تو فينيش ليسون 3. اتس اباوت ذا لاست بارت ان هالوجين. وي ستارتد ذا هالوجينز لاست تايم. وي توكد اباوت هالوجينز ذير فيزيكال ستيت. They exist, as we said before, in the form of diatomic molecule. And today, now, inshallah, we are going to study some reactions about halogens. And in the first place, to answer the question اللي احنا سألناه المرة اللي فاتت, why they are called this name. ليه اسمهم halogen؟ جي منين الاسم ده؟ Why? As you see in lesson 3, ده بيعتبر كأنه application على what we have studied before. انت لو مذاكر كويس lesson 2 وفاهم المين بارتس بتاعته, lesson 3 just application على what you have studied before. يلا نبتدي النهارده الحلقه بتاعتنا و let's finish lesson 3. Let's start our session. This part is talking about some chemical properties of halogens. They react with metals, metals in group 1A or other, forming salts. But they react with metals to form salt. Salt, by the way, like table salt. You know, of course, table salt, sodium chloride. So they are called halogen. This is why they are called halogens. Halogen, this word means salt formation. So as because they react with metal to form salt, they are called the halogens. That means salt formation. شو هما بيعملوا salts لأنهم react with metals, فعشان كده سموهم halogens, because the word halogens means salt formation. Let's watch this video about يعني some reactions of halogen with metal. يلا نشوفوا مع بعض.
Alkali metals have low ionization energies. They easily give up their one valence electron to form a plus one ion. This property makes these metals quite reactive. And as you go down the group on the periodic table, the reactivity increases. Let's look at some examples. Alkali metals react with group 7 elements to form ionic compounds. Sodium loses its one valence electron to chlorine, giving each newly formed ion a stable noble gas configuration.
What did you understand from this video? فهمتوا ايه منه؟ الفيديو ده كان عايز يقول لنا ايه؟ As you see, ان الصوديوم loses one electron, كان عنده one electron in the last shell. فالصوديوم loses one electron, this electron is gained by chlorine. As you see in this case, chlorine is chlorine has 8 electrons في last shell, and هو كان already عنده 7 electrons in level M, كان عنده 7 electrons. Once it gains 1 electron from sodium, as you see now, it becomes 8. Let's count 2, 2, and 2, 2. يبقى now chlorine is stable because it reaches the بيقولوا عليها octane number, أو يعني إن هو بقى زي النوبل جاس. فاكرين لما خدنا البروبرتي دي في lesson 2 وقلنا إن النون metals tends to gain electrons to fill the last energy level to look like the inert gas that follow them. أهو الكلورين بان قدامنا أهو إن هو it gains one electron and now it contains in the last level 8 electrons. فبقى شبه مين تفتكروا؟ بقى شبه الأرجون. Yes, it contains now 18 electron as an ion. In the other hand, sodium, as you see, it lost one electron, اللي هو outermost electron, هو خلاص lost it, فبقى عنده just 8 electron في second level بتاعه. This compound, this newly formed compound, is called NaCl. يبقى again, if we have two sodium atoms, two Na plus one chlorine molecule Cl2, we said before the halogens are written this way, they are existing in this way in the form of diatomic molecule. The molecule contains two atoms, this is why we write it this way, Cl2. يبقى let's talk a little bit about the numbers in this equation. عندنا الصوديوم 2 before sodium. ال 2 دي معناها ايه؟ I have got 2 atoms of sodium. Sodium and another sodium. This will react with whom? With chlorine molecule. And the molecule of chlorine contains just 2 atoms of chlorine combined together with covalent compound, of course. So each sodium atom, as you see in the graph, will lose قلنا يعني في الرسمة اللي فاتت أو في الفيديو اللي فات كان مورينا إنه الصوديوم loses one electron that's gained by chlorine. Another chlorine atom in this molecule gained one more electron from the other sodium atom. This is why we have got a molecule of sodium chloride. But how many molecules have we got? We have got 2 molecules of sodium chloride. 2 NaCl. NaCl, it is the ordinary table salt. الملح اللي احنا بنحطه على الأكل العادي بتاعنا. This figure, I guess it represents the reaction very well. زي ما شايفين كده في one of the sodium electrons removed totally from sodium and so the sodium changed into positive ion. زي ما شايفين بقى positive ion. Well, chlorine also becomes negative ion. Here the sodium is positive. After it loses one electron, well, chlorine gains this electron and becomes negative ion. Yeah, but this is why they are called halogens, because they form salt with metals as they are, in this case, halogens. Halogens means salt formation. So, fluorine or chlorine or bromine or iodine or acetine, they react with metals forming salts, so they are called halogen, أو معناها salt formation. Like in this case, 2K, K means potassium, plus Br2, this gives 2KBr, or for example, sodium with chlorine, it gives sodium chloride. تعالوا ناخد الكيميكال reactions دي, let's explain these reactions more, and we'll get also another more reaction, but on the board. Yalla, let's go. طب يا شباب احنا we are going to study actually two examples for two different equations, but let's remember first the arrangement of alkali metals, sorry, halogens, اللي هم أسميهم كالآتي: fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. I said before you need to memorize them with this order. يعني يا ريت نحفظهم بالترتيب كده. This will be easier for you to answer any equation or anything that will be asked about them. The first equation that I want to tell you about, of course, we can write them this way, F2 or Cl2 or Br2 or I2. It means the molecule exists in the form of diatomic molecule. That's number one. طيب, أنا عايزة أقول لكم two equations. الإكوشن الأولى اللي هي موضوع salt formation. How do these elements forming a salt with a metal? Or let's take an example from the alkali metals. تعالوا كده نبتدي نشوف هنعمل ايه. لو قلنا انا عندي 2 Na plus let's say Cl2, this will give 2 NaCl. NaCl, it's salt, table salt. Okay, let's explain this more. Of course, we have 2 Na, I mean we have 2 atoms of Na, I mean Na, and one more Na this way. Each of them contains one electron. I represented this one electron by a dot. In addition, I have chlorine, and it's a Cl2. Let's say I have here 2 atoms in this molecule, 2 chlorine atoms, and each of them needs one electron. Seems like this, Cl and Cl, each of them will get this one electron. This is why we wrote it this way, NaCl, and another NaCl, it's 2 NaCl. This is how to write such equation. Okay, this is number one. Number two, that I want to tell you about is about their activity. What about their activity? The activity of halogens graduated as you move from up to down, because fluorine, it's the most active one, the biggest star, the most active one, and then chlorine, less active, and then bromine, much more less active. So the activity of halogen in this case decreases, بتقل هي شوية بشوية, and then finally الأيودين. يعني ال activity decreases. نعملها كده نقول إيه decreases. Okay. So because the activity decreases, each of them can replace the other below it in its salt solution. يعني إيه؟ يعني if I have a compound that contains a salt solution, يعني مثلا let's say نقول مثلا sodium bromide NaBr. If I have NaBr, in this case the Br can be replaced by the one above it, اللي هو chlorine. يعني أقدر أقول كده Cl2 plus NaBr. To balance the equation, I need to write the 2 here. This will give 2NaCl plus Br2. As you see here, because el bromine in a compound with sodium, let's take sodium bromide with bromine, it's called sodium bromide. Sodium bromide, it's a compound, a salt. In this solution, يعني let's dissolve it. The solution ده لو أنا جبته وخليت فيه chlorine to pass in this solution, so the chlorine can remove the bromine, replace it, يقعد مكانه, فتبقى NaCl and the bromine released, يخرج البرومين. يبقى in this case, as we said, each element of them has the ability to replace the one below it. ليه؟ Because it's more active than it. So يبقى الفلورين يقدر يريبليس كلورين, كلورين يقدر يريبليس البرومين, برومين can replace iodine in its salt solution. يبقى any of them can replace the other because it's much more stronger. يعني بما انه اقوى, الكلورين اقوى من البرومين, فit can remove البرومين in this compound sodium bromide. يطرد البرومين برا this way, ويتبقى لي الكلورين يقعد مكانه يبقى sodium chloride. This is a famous equation that you should know in this lesson. يبقى again, we study in this part two examples for two equations. How to form a salt like sodium with chlorine, it gives sodium chloride. The other part, how any of the halogen can replace the other one below it, because if we have one active, يعني one more active than the other, it can replace it. Like in this case, we have chlorine, it can replace the bromine in the salt solution of sodium bromide. Okay, يبقى دول two important equations or examples, the equations. In fact, let's continue our session with the whole equation in this part. يلا نكمل. يبقى يا شباب, let's talk about the chemical reactions of alkali metals. Number one, salt formation. زي ما قلنا 2K plus Br2. This can be applied طبعا in any other alkali metal. يعني instead of saying potassium, هنا عندنا K potassium, ممكن نقول sodium, ممكن نقول lithium, أي واحد تاني, أي element تاني من الألكلاي metals. يبقى 2K plus Br2 bromine Br2. This will give 2K Br. It's يعني try to read it with me. Potassium bromide. Potassium bromide. The other equation is about sodium, or another alkali metal. Sodium 2Na plus chlorine Cl2. This will give, let's read it, sodium chloride. يبقى we have potassium bromide, potassium and bromine, sodium and chlorine, it is sodium chloride. As we said on the board, each element replaces the element below it in the periodic table in its sole solution. For example, if we have chlorine, it can replace the bromine in potassium bromide. نلسى عملنا لكم واحدة شبهها من شوية. يبقى الكلورين replaces البرومين here. So let's read it together. It will be potassium chloride and bromine release. Also chlorine plus 2NaBr sodium bromide. This will give 2NaCl plus Br2. It means Cl, the chlorine, replaces the bromine, and this will give sodium chloride and bromine release. The last example here is bromine with potassium iodide. I here means iodine. يبقى Br2 plus 2Ki, it gives 2KBr plus I2, iodine, potassium bromide and iodine. يبقى as you see, each one is stronger than the other, can replace it. يعني عندي الكلورين replaces الكلورين replaces for example bromine, bromine replaces iodine and so on. By this part, يعني we almost finish all chemical equations or reactions. لكن يتبقى لنا some applications. إيه بقى الapplications؟ في four elements selected من hold the table. أنا أخذ منهم بس just a اليوسج بتاعتهم بنعمل بيهم really في الحياة. لأن كتير من الستودنتس بيسألوا طب يعني why should we study all of this, what is the benefit of studying such elements and what for. This is basic science. احنا لازم نعرف الكلام ده عشان نقدر نشوف بعد كده الحاجات اللي حوالينا في الحياة ماشية ازاي. Number one, the properties of elements and their uses. هناخد الصوديوم. Sodium used in liquid state. Of course sodium is metal. They make it in liquid state to transfer the heat from inside the nuclear reactor to outside. إيه بقى قصة النيوكليار ريأكتور؟ في some places اسمها نيوكليار ريأكتور بتستخدم نيوكليار انرجي. You may study this in detail later on, ويمكن عندكم كده شوية معلومات عنها, يعني معلوماتكم العامة. فالنيوكليار ريأكتور دي بتبقى أماكن مهمة جدا إنها to produce energy, لإنتاج الطاقة يعني. فـ in fact inside the reactor the inside of the core of the reactor contains a lot amount of heat. This heat, if it's kept trapped in the reactor, لو فضلت محبوسة جوه reactor, this may cause يعني explosion, a big one, وده cause damage to a big area. يعني ده يعمل انفجارات ويعمل مشاكل ل very wide areas around. فعشان كده to release this heat, عايزين نخرجها من inside to outside. عشان to avoid any explosion or any damage to the reactor, this heat should transfer outside. By whom? By a metal. Metal can conduct heat very easily. فعشان كده they use sodium in liquid state to transfer heat from inside the reactor to outside. وبعدين طب الهيت دي تخرج تروح فين؟ This heat is used, or let's say they allow this heat to pass on water, and then the water change into steam, والsteam ده used to get electricity. بيخلوا الsteam اللي طلع ده أو water vapor اللي طلع ده يطلعوا منه أو يشغل يعني machines to get electricity or to generate electricity. يبقى نقراها تاني. It's used, sodium used in liquid state to transfer heat from inside the nuclear reactor to outside. And this heat is used to obtain the vapor or the يعني steam. This steam is required to generate electricity. بقدر أجيب منه electricity. عشان كده مهم قوي موضوع nuclear reactors. It's a new يعني a source, important source of getting electricity. How? This way, to transfer الheat. الheat this heat passes through water. Well, water دي can generate electricity with some machines. What else? That's sodium. Well, by the way, this is important point in applications. يعني دايما احنا نتسأل في applications of some elements. يقول لك sodium used in what type. Next one عندي الكوبالت. The radioactive cobalt 60 is a substance called cobalt. It's radioactive, يعني it means it emits some radiations, بتطلع some radiations. الراديشن زي like gamma rays. الجاما rays دي عندها الابيليتي to kill microbes, تقدر تقتل microbes but without any harm to the human. فعشان كده they use it in food preservation instead of using for example preservation substance or artificial substances to preserve the food. الراديشنز اللي produced من الجاما is better, لانه من sorry من الكوبالت. الراديشنز دي اسمها جاما rays. جاما rays دي produced من الكوبالت has the ability to prevent the reproduction of microbial cells, يعني kill microbes, doesn't allow microbes to grow on food, so this will preserve the food. يبقى radioactive cobalt 60 used in food preservation because it radiates gamma rays, produce gamma rays which prevent the reproduction, the growing or the increasing in number of microbial cells without any effect on human. ملهاش تأثير على الإنسان أو يعني تأثيرها مش harmful. Silicon. Of course silicon is a future in microchips أو electronics. كل الإلكترونيكس or devices اللي هي في حياتنا based on in their manufacture based on silicon. It is used in manufacturing of electronics زي الكمبيوترز وكل الأجهزة الحديثة اللي في إيدينا دلوقتي. Why? Because it's a semiconductor as its ability to conduct electricity depends on the temperature. السيليكون ده من الحاجات يعني المهمة قوي في الإلكترونيك manufacturing. Nitrogen. Liquid nitrogen actually. Actually nitrogen exists in nature in gaseous state. But they transfer it into liquid state. In this case they can use nitrogen after putting this nitrogen in gaseous state under high pressure and with very low temperature. This will transfer nitrogen from the gaseous state to liquid state. This is liquefied nitrogen. Liquefied nitrogen means nitrogen in liquid state. Nitrogen in liquid state, it's used in preserving of or preservation of cornea of the eye. There's a part in the eye that helps us to see, which is called cornea. To transfer cornea from يعني human being to another, احيانا بعض الناس يعني بتعمل transplanting للكورنيا او تزرع كورنيا عشان تقدر تشوف من بعض يعني الدونرز او المتبرعين بيها. فto preserve this cornea, لان ده living tissues very sensitive to temperature, للروم temperature طبعا هتتأثر وممكن يحصل لها damage. فto preserve it, to keep it as it is, they put it in liquefied nitrogen. Why? يبقى again it's used in preserving of cornea of the eye due to this liquid nitrogen, due to the decrease in its boiling point. It reaches negative 196, negative 196 زي ما شايفين very low temperature. احنا الفريزر عندنا في البيت let's say ان هو negative 4 ولو جينا كده مسكناه بنقول يا ده الدنيا very cold. ده بقى negative 196. Okay, this is why it's caused or it's used in preservation of cornea of the eye. Now let's check our understanding by having some question as usual. Yalla, choose the correct answer. Space in its salt solution. What? Chlorine replace bromine, iodine replace chlorine, bromine replace fluorine or iodine replace fluorine. To know this, you should memorize the arrangement: fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. So which one can replace the other? Yes, chlorine هو اللي can replace bromine. ما نقدرش نقول iodine replace chlorine لأن iodine ده آخر واحد تحت. It can't replace what's stronger than it. يعني الايودين أضعف ما ينفعش ياخد مكان الكلورين. وهكذا في البي. إذا chlorine can replace bromine. Write scientific term, the type of phrase. What is the type of phrase which are emitted from cobalt 60? Cobalt 60 emits rays, قلنا used in food preservation. Yes, it's gamma rays. Gamma rays. Answer the following question. Write down the chemical equation which illustrate bromine with sodium iodide. This is important question. how to write an equation وبتجيلي بالشكل ده ممكن انها by words and you should replace these words by symbols of the equation and write the full balanced equation. اكتبها ازاي؟ bromine it's br وقلنا تبقى br2 لان هي exists in the form of diatomic molecule وبعد كده plus 2Na I in sodium iodide NaI iodide يعني I NaI this will give 2NaBr plus I2 يبقى you need to find each word and replace it with the symbol and then write the equation. Let's get one more question. Group 17 elements are known as halogens. Why they are called halogen? Because they are reacting with metal forming salts. And finally, one of the famous question in this part, all the exams contain such a question. يجي يديلك بس اللي هو الفور elements اللي قلنا عليهم الصوديوم والكوبالت والنيتروجين الحاجات دي والسيليكون يسألني اليوسج بتاعت each one. ناخد example عليها الكوبالت 60 بيعمل ايه؟ قلنا used in food preservation والليكويد صوديوم used to transfer the heat from inside the reactor to outside. This application is very important. ناخد بالنا من الابليكيشنز دايما بتبقى a place where we may be asked about. بكده نكون وصلنا لنهاية حلقتنا النهاردة. أتمنى تكونوا استفدتوا ويبقى كده خلصنا lesson 3 the main groups in the modern periodic table. Stay safe and see you next time إن شاء الله.